Today we're going to talk about the new Netflix series, I Am Not Okay With This. So let's get started. Hey everybody, my name is Justin. I love to watch movies. If you guys love to watch movies too and Netflix, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below and click that bell notification for more up and coming videos. Today we're talking about the new Netflix original series, I Am Not Okay With This, which is based off of a comic book graphic novel of the same name, which I have not read. And this is about a young girl who is navigating high school life, family, and her sexuality while dealing with her new superpowers. Sophia Lillis plays Sydney in the show. She is most recognized for her role in It. And this is a reunion of sorts. Why Olaf is in this show. He also was in the movie It. I was looking forward to this Netflix show. Most Netflix shows that I do watch are about 45 to an hour long. And so it was a bit of a shock to see this show, which only had 7 episodes, and each episode ran between 19 minutes and 28 minutes. So it was a really, really quick watch, and it does leave on an epic, epic cliffhanger for a second season, which I'm not going to spoil for anybody, but I am really looking forward to a season 2. This show has a good mixture of different genres, such as thriller and horror elements. There's also some romance in there. There's some comedy. It takes a lot of elements from like John Hughes stories, like Breakfast Club. Different movies like that. I felt that theme within the show and how she is dealing with her sexuality, different friends in high school, the complexity around that. And I think that the show did a great job of blending different genres within it, because from the trailer, we also see that she has superpowers. When she gets really angry about something, she can't control her powers and she just unleashes it. And the powers never seem like it's the main part of the show. It's the relationship with her friends, her neighbors, and her family, and how she's dealing with all of this while going through high school. And then she has the superpowers as well. So I'd fully expect the season 2 to have the superpowers come play a bigger part in the show, but for the first season, they had the superpowers. It was introduced really early on, but kind of took a backseat for a part of the show, and most of the show was centered around her relationships with her friends and family. Sophia Lillis does a great job of being socially awkward. She doesn't know how to control her powers. She doesn't know how to express her feelings. So I think she did a great job of being that awkward girl while also trying to have fun as well. Why Olaf plays her neighbor, and they have a complex relationship. I did enjoy him in the show as well. The show does a good job of developing Sydney as a character. She's dealing a lot with her life. She's dealing with the death of her father while also handling these new powers, her sexuality. They add a lot to this character within the 7 episode series, and I was surprised at how much we got to know the character and a lot of the development going into her character throughout the show, because it's really not that long of a series compared to like Stranger Things or Ozark, how long those shows are. This is a really brief show, and that was one thing I was worried about, is you're not going to have a lot of time to develop the character. They did a good job developing her feelings and her relationships with her family fairly well within this limited time that they had. But that is one of the issues for me, is I was left wanting more for this show. So I'm not okay with the runtime, because I wanted to see more of the powers. I wanted to see that develop, but I understand that it's based off of a graphic novel comic book, and I want to see a lot of that come to play in their second season, because how they ended it, a couple cliffhangers, I did not see coming. I thought, oh my gosh, this is something so cool. I want to see it in a second season. So I'm hoping that the second season does a lot more with her powers while also still blending the moments of the high school elements and relationships as well, while also progressing the superpowers. So I think it'd be really cool, and I'm really looking forward to the second season. I Am Not Okay With This was a great short watch. I enjoyed the acting. I enjoyed the blending of the different genres. It felt like a John Hughes movie at time. It had a Carrie vibe as well going for it. So there's a lot that I did enjoy about this. And if you do like John Hughes movies and comic books
and some of the younger stars from the movie It. I think you will enjoy this. It's a really quick watch. I think the first episode was like 19 minutes, and the one that was the longest was 28 minutes. So it is a really quick watch, only 7 episodes, so you can breeze through it. But really do appreciate all of the different blending of the genres and the acting. It's a fun, fun show that you're left wanting more, but you're highly anticipating a second season. So I'm going to go ahead and give I Am Not Okay With This Season 1, because I'm sure this is going to be a Season 2, a B+. Thank you guys for checking my Netflix review for I Am Not Okay With This. Stay tuned, I got a review for a bunch of Netflix content that I am excited to share with you guys. My name is Just Watch Movies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.